Now here we come to a very important problem, and I want to listen to it carefully. A string oscillates according to an equation, and we're given that equation equals 0.50 centimeters times the sine of, we have pi over 3 inverse centimeter times x, and the cosine of 40 pi inverse seconds t. Now if we see that, we immediately know that it is two waves traveling in the opposite direction because of the way that this equation is stated. In other words, we're looking here at a standing wave being created. Remember that. Now they want to know what are the amplitude and the speed of the two waves. Now the speed will be identical, just in opposite directions, whose superposition gives this oscillation. So they want to know the ym of the two identical waves traveling and what the velocity is going to be, absolute value, because one will be positive and one will be negative. Now just looking at this, when they have the same amplitude come together and they interfere, somewhere in that standing wave will be a maximum amplitude. And that maximum amplitude in this equation is given by this half a centimeter. In other words, y prime's max equals 2 times y max. And remember, it is then the cosine of kx. But at the spot where it is maximum, if the two waves come together and they interfere, it's going to be double the amplitude of those original two. So it will be the sine of whatever, but the maximum value of that will be 1. So it will be the sine of pi over 2, which is pi over 2, which is 1. So y max, y, the amplitude is going to be y max of this standing wave divided by 2. So that's going to leave us with 0.25 centimeters. That equals 0.25 centimeters. So just look at this carefully. This tells you the standing wave has been set up. Now I know we said that y max prime equals 2 times ym sine of kx. That was our fact, that was our y max factor. And if we looked at the original equation, which we said that was going to be this 2 y max sine of kx, and then that was your y max prime, and then your oscillating factor was omega t. And that was your oscillating factor. But when it is written like this, remember there's a standing wave. The standing wave is now created. And there are going to be nodes, and there are going to be node, and there are going to be anti-nodes. When it's written like this, it means that the maximum is going to be with this value. Don't be concerned about this whole part up till there. It is going to be the maximum value where they interfere and cause maximum displacement from y equals 0 equilibrium. And that is given by that. And in your mind, think about it, if two of them come together, they are of identical amplitude, the maximum that it's ever going to be is twice the original amplitudes. And that's going to happen at specific x values, you are going to get this maximum. But the maximum that it can be will be twice each individual wave's amplitude. And that's how we get to half a centimeter. And we're not doing as yet any calculus on this problem or anything else. As it stands, I think you can just leave these in centimeters. We don't have to change them now. If we have to do some arithmetic on this, some algebra or calculus on this, we might have to change this all to SI units. Now the velocity, what is velocity going to be? So this was a very important look, you know, this is an important problem that if you are going to get, realize what is going on here and what this half centimeter there means. We know two equations that are very important to us, and that is omega equals 2 pi times the frequency in the angular, this angular frequency, the angular wave number is 2 pi over lambda. Remember those two old friends of ours. They are quite important. We also know velocity equals frequency times wavelength. And we can rewrite this, frequency equals omega over 2 pi. We've done these problems before, lambda equals 2 pi over k. If we substitute those in there, for frequency is omega divided by 2 pi, times for lambda is 2 pi over k, in other words, velocity equals omega over k. We've done that before. We know how to get there. We can just memorize that. So do we know what's going on here? Do we know the angular frequency? We do know it's 40 pi inverse seconds. Do we know k? Yes, we do. There it is, pi over 3. So that'll be pi over 3 inverse centimeters. The pi's will cancel out, the 3 will go to the denominator, so we are going to be left with 120 centimeters per second. And this is two significant digits, so we can rewrite this as 1.2 times 10 to the power times 10 to the power negative 2 meters per second. Now for the last bit, which is the interesting one. Oh, second last one. What is the distance between the nodes? Remember, from node to node equals a half times lambda. Do we know lambda? We do. It's 2 pi over k. So we're just going to have a half of lambda, which is 2 pi over k. That will be 1, so pi over k is pi over 3, that means that's 3 over pi, that cancels out, and we are left with 3.0 centimeters. Just remember, from node to antinode is a quarter wavelength, but from node to node is half a wavelength. Now for the interesting one. Where were we? What is the transverse speed of a particle of the string at the position x equals 1.5 centimeters and the time equals 9/8 seconds? We have a standing wave. There is no transverse movement. There is no transverse movement. That wave is standing still right there. And even if you put a value for x in here and you put a value for t in there, and you take partial derivatives, we have a constant, we have a constant, we have a constant. This transverse velocity was going to be dt. But this is a constant, we put in a specific x and a specific t value, so this whole thing is a constant, and the first derivative or the derivative of any constant equals 0. So you can do it mathematically, the derivative of a constant equals 0, or this is a standing wave. Nothing is moving up and down here at all. There is no transverse velocity. Let us do another interesting problem. Again, a rope is under tension, and we are given the tension as it is 200 newtons, kilogram meters per second squared, and fixed at both ends, it oscillates in the second harmonic. It oscillates in the second harmonic, so we've got a standing wave, and the displacement of the rope is given by, this is going to be slightly weird, it is given by 0.10 meters, Then the sine of, and all we're given here is pi over 2x, and again the sine, not cosine, of 12 pi t. So that looks a bit odd then, in as much as that doesn't have a cosine. It does not matter. I'm telling you now, it does not matter. And let's take x in meters, and this as the inverse meter, and that in seconds, and the inverse second. Let's take that. And we're told that x equals 0 at the one end of the rope. What is the length of the rope? Just from that information, can we discern the length of the rope? Can we discern the length of the rope? Now, we do have omega, and we do have k. What we do know from k is, it's 2 pi divided by the length. 2 pi divided by, not the length, I'm ahead of myself here, 2 pi divided by lambda. In other words, lambda is going to equal 2 pi over k. So we can deduce what lambda is, or we can calculate what lambda is going to be. K is pi over 2, pi, 2 times 2 is 4, so it's going to be 4.0 meters. It is in the second harmonic. What happens in the second harmonic? Node, anti-node. Guess what? In the second harmonic, a whole wavelength fits in the distance L. So in the second harmonic, L equals lambda. In other words, L for us is going to be 4.0 meters. 4.0 meters. We could have also used this equation to get L, and we know what this is, but we can just, there are two ways to do it. As I said, you can use this, so you can get L on one side, and for lambda, you'll just have to use this for lambda, so you'll get an equation just for L, or you can just use your Gray method, but you just realize in the second harmonic, L equals the wavelength, and you're going to get exactly the same equation. Okay, so two ways to solve that problem. What is the speed of the waves on the rope? So they just want the velocity of the waves on the rope. And we know very easily now, let's make some space quickly. We know velocity, and we're not going to go through that derivation again, equals omega over k. And what is important here is it doesn't matter that that is the sine. It doesn't matter that that is. We're just going to be left with omega, which is 12 pi. Now 12 becomes 11, I'm not sure. So that's 12 times pi divided by k, which is pi over 2. And that's going to equal 24 meters per second. You could have also, now that you know, you could have also used the omega, well, this is the whole derivation. Let's not do that anymore. So don't be concerned that this is not the cosine. It'll be 12 pi as omega. Next one. What is the mass of the rope? We know another equation. We know that velocity equals the square root of tau length divided by mass, because if you bring that in the denominator here, it will be mass over length, which is mu. So v squared is going to be tau length divided by mass, and the mass is going to be tau l divided by v squared. And I think I did that before on the board. That leaves me with a mass of, no, I didn't do it. Let me just check on my calculator here. That leaves me with a mass of 1.4 kilograms. So the mass will be 1.4 kilograms. Good, it was easy enough. If the rope oscillates in a third harmonic standing wave pattern, what will the period be of oscillation? Our period equals 1 over the frequency. We know frequency should have an n there. So period is going to be 1 over this. In other words, n times v. So period of 3 will be 2 times the length, which was, where did we do the length? The length was 4 meters. So 2 times 4 meters divided by 1 the third harmonic, and our velocity was 24 meters per second. Meters cancel, second will go up. So that'll be in seconds. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 over 24 is 1 over 3. 3 times 3 is 9. That'll be 1 over 9 seconds, or that should be 0.11 seconds thereabout. So all in all, it's easy. Don't be concerned about that. And remember that the second harmonic, the length of the rope, equals exactly the wavelength. We still have omega, and we still have k.